Alright guys, quick video today, it's only about 8 minutes long. We've had a client call us recently regarding a tilt tray. That's what we call them here in Australia and other countries. You might know them as highway recovery vehicles. Pick up broken cars, the back of the tray moves back and actually tilts down. And if the car's broken, there's usually a winch, which will winch it back up onto the tray. The tray then comes into the level position and they drive away. The customer's been complaining that while on the road, the tray's actually slowly moving back, and that shouldn't happen. We tried installing some valves, but that didn't seem to work. We tried installing some load hold valves. Customer says they didn't seem to be working, which kind of suggested to us that there was internal leakage inside the long cylinder, so the oil was bypassing from possibly the piston seals in the cylinder. So he brought it back to us, gave us 2 days to do the job. We haven't done one of them before. It's quite an involved job, so this video actually shows us moving the tray back, retracting, disconnecting the pins, retracting the long rod back, getting the forklift to then pull the tray even further back, exposing the cylinder so we can remove the cylinder. It then shows us dismantling the cylinder in the workshop. Unfortunately, due to rushing, we didn't actually show the assembly, testing, and reinstallation. It seems like everything went well. Customer hasn't called us to complain that it's not correct or not right. So anyway, it's a quick video. A lot of it's sped up quite dramatically, and I'll explain the procedure as we move along.
Okay, so the tray's been moved partially back. And the guys are getting ready to disconnect the rod pin from the end of the rod, which is just there. Now the pin's been removed, and we're trying to find the right lever to actually move and retract the rod. Eventually they get it right, and they will retract the rod 100%. Come on guys, get your act together. Get the right lever. Okay, here we go. So once the rod has been fully retracted, pardon me, they will then disconnect some of the hoses going to the winch, disconnect some of the electrics, disconnect the hoses, go to the actual tilt tray cylinder, or the tray that actually retracts the tray, pushes the tray back. So the two hoses that were connected to the pipes on the cylinder have now been disconnected, and we're slowly pulling the tray back with the forklift, just to expose the main tray retract cylinder. So the guys are now going to manhandle the tray, manhandle the cylinder out, and I'm wondering why didn't they use the forklift? But they couldn't use the forklift because the forklift's at the end of the tray, being supporting the tray. So they're going to have to do this the hard way with muscle power to move the cylinder first up and out of the truck, and then onto a one of our benches. All our benches are on casters, lockable casters, so we can actually move them around the workshop with heavy loads on them. Rather than moving the loads, we just move the benches. So here's the guys actually putting it onto one of the workbenches, and then they'll move it into the workshop and start disassembly. of the cylinder in the workshop. So this is inside the workshop. This is our very rudimentary cylinder breakout bench, which is actually a floor-mounted vise. You'd be surprised how much work we can accomplish with this. This is removing the gland nut. We need quite a... These are usually done up extremely tight, and as you can see, a lot of purchase is required to eventually break the thread that actually holds the gland nut on to the end of the cylinder. So here we are removing the gland nut from the end of the barrel. This actually supports the rod, and it has internal and external seals to prevent oil leaking out. So this is all the excess oil in the barrel being drained before they start to remove the rod and the piston from the barrel. They're starting to remove the rod from the barrel, and they said, no, we don't have enough room, so they've relocated it to a different angle. And again, because the forklift's not being used, it's all manpower to dismantle this. Otherwise, we'd be using the forklift to pull this out. So here comes the piston assembly on the end of the rod. So this piston assembly has actually got what's called a stroke limiter. So it doesn't actually go too far back. That grey tube, steel tube there, will prevent the rod from retracting, and rod and the piston from retracting too far, which could cause some damage to the bearings and or the rod. So we're about to remove the big nut on the end of the piston, and I think somewhere around here the lunch lady comes and all work pretty much screeches to a halt. We're just removing the seals off the end of the piston at the moment. You can see some seals on the ground there already. The orange things are actually called wear bands or support rings. They're actually a hard plastic material. So here comes the lunch girl, and pretty much everybody forgot about filming, so there was just 20 minutes of people being served and not much happening, which obviously you're not going to see. Come on, guys. So the customer actually supplied us the seals, and once we started to put the seals into the cleaned up gland nut, we realized that one of the seals was the wrong size, which actually caused us an extra 24 hours delay to actually organize and order the correct seals. Normally we don't do it this way. Because of these issues, we'll actually measure metal to metal dimensions and actually send the dimensions to a supplier. So here we are. I was wrong, we did actually film testing. So here we are doing a full load test with our test bench. Going to full extension under high pressure and full retract under high pressure. And we do that by restricting the inlets and the outlets so that the barrel works under full pressure. Successful test, and so far so good.